Assalamu alaikum, dear Falconians. Hello there. How are you all today? Do you know our today's topic? It's factors affecting climate. Which are the factors which affect the climate? Today, we will talk about it. All these factors which influence the climate. Right, guys? Again, hey guys, let's start today's topic. Do you know the different factors which are affecting climate? Let's start it. These factors are the latitude, elevation, nearby water. Yes, if you are living nearby the water, the stream or the river or the ocean, then such thing will affect your climate. The ocean currents, do you know the ocean current? Yes, the waves of the ocean. Topography. What is topography? Does anyone know? Oh, that's good. Topography means the geographical feature of that particular area. The vegetation, whatever the vegetation of this area is, and the prevailing winds. Winds, remember? Okay, let's start it. Okay, guys, look at this globe. Latitude, surface temperature vary with latitude. Do you remember the latitude? It was in our very first chapter, the maps, and then we have talked about it in this chapter as well. So if our area is nearby the surface of sun, or nearby such any area of ocean maybe, then such thing will be effective for on our climate. Right, guys? Now, places located at high latitude far from the equator. Do you remember the equator line? Yes, the middle line of the globe where we receive more sunlight. Remember, these area receives less sunlight than places at low latitude close to the equator. So places which are at high latitudes, far away from the equator, receives less sunlight because they are far from the equator. That's why they receive less rays, right? Okay. Now, look at these mountains. Wow, we are receiving the cool wind. Elevation. Climate zones coincide roughly with elevation ranges. You know, look at such area topography. We are having different elevation. That's why climate zone coincide roughly. Altitude. Yes. Altitude affects climate in that, the higher up you get. The higher means if you are on a mountain, then the climate will affect you. The more the temperature drops. So if you are on a peak of a mountain, then the temperature will be drop. Yes, it will be cool breeze. Now, look at this coastal area. Look at this. Maybe whether it's a river or maybe it's a sea. So, if you are nearby the water, then you must be enjoying, right? Because the sea surface temperatures affect land temperature. You know, the water always give you a very good mild weather, right? Do you remember our sea view and all the seaside cool weathers and the wind we get from there? Okay. Wow, look at the reasons of it. Water heats and cools more slowly. Yes, slowly it affects than the land. Therefore, in the summer, the coastal regions will stay cooler. Are you living in a cooler area? Yes, we are. And in winter, warmer or a mild winter. A more moderate climate with a smaller temperature range is created. Yay! glow. So you can see these lines, the red and the blue lines. These are the current. Current means waves, that where this ocean water is moving around. Ocean currents. Water temperatures indicate transfer of heat energy by the currents. Yes, the water currents transfer the heat energy. Do you know these things? No? Then it's okay. I told you that ocean currents transfer the heat energy from one area to another. Now I hope you got it. So let's talk more about the current. Currents regulate global climate because we are receiving the current all over the ocean, and the 70% of our globe consists of the ocean. That's right. That's why currents regulate global climate, helping to contract the uneven distribution of solar radiation reaching Earth's surface. Uneven distribution means if we are on our equator, then we are having the more sunlight. If we are far from the equator, then we will have less sunlight. Yes, that's right. All right, guys. Topography. Do you know topography? I told you the geographical features. Whether you are in desert area, whether you are in mountainous area. So local variations in the elevation can cause the local variation in the climate. Of course, if you are living in a mountain, then you are having a very good weather over there. That's good. I am kind of jealous right now because we are facing summer over here in the plain and the coastal areas. So topography do influence the climate change. Right, guys? So the topography of an area can greatly influence our climate. As I told you, mountain ranges are natural barriers to air movement. You know, these mountain ranges are the barrier to move air from one area to another, and these mountain ranges can cause what? Exactly, rain and snowfall. And these mountains give us fresh water right from the glaciers. We are having fresh water. Wow, the greenery, the vegetation, the forest, type of a ground cover, and seasonal changes affect climate. If you are in a forest, then you will have a mild temperature, a good temperature. That's why we are emphasizing you all that do not cut the trees. Trees are very effective to have a good atmosphere and a good climate. Right, guys? So remember, you need to have more trees. You need to grow more trees. Do not waste all the seeds of your fruits and just grow them to have a good climate. Yes, very much true. Vegetation affects climate because it influences the reflection of our solar energy. Do you remember that thing? That these plants make oxygen, which is very much necessity, very much use of in humans. So the reflection of solar energy from the Earth's surface and the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere, what are these things are caused by? The vegetation. Yes, that's right. Okay, guys. Now, prevailing winds. Remember the winds? Winds are the movement of air. So, prevailing winds, remember winds? The movement of the air. So, prevailing winds deliver air masses with specific properties. Properties, what type of properties? Like the hot wind and the cool breeze. So such kind of properties. Yes, the direction of the local winds is determined by the daily temperature variations. When the air over the land is warmer than the air over a body, the wind blows from the water to the land and is called a sea breeze. Being a Karachi people, we are having sea breeze whenever the local winds flow towards the seashore. Then we receive cool sea breeze and then we enjoyed it. So my dear Falconians, I hope that now all these factors are in your mind and you can describe them more easily. Right guys? I hope you enjoyed it and I want you to note down all the class assignment regarding this topic. See ya!